Behind every problem in your life, God has a purpose. There is a purpose behind every problem. In fact, I almost feel like Christianity is kind of one of those things where we need to have a big warning sticker that says, warning, in order to become like Christ, you're probably going to go through similar things that Jesus went through. That's kind of a given. If you want to be like Jesus, you're going to have to go through some of the things that he went through. Well, what did Jesus go through? Was Jesus criticized? Yes. Were there obstacles in his way? Yes. Did Jesus have people that were haters? Yes. Was Jesus abandoned by some of his closest friends? Yes. Was he betrayed? Yes. He was even crucified. If God didn't allow problems to perfect us and change us, well, then the Bible wouldn't be filled with stories like we've seen. Joseph would have never been thrown in jail. Daniel would have never been put in the lion's den. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego would have never went into a fiery furnace. Paul would have never been shipwrecked three times. And Jesus himself was crucified. If the whole goal of becoming saved, becoming a believer, saying yes to God and saying, I want to follow God all the days of my life, if the goal of that is a perfect, sin-free, problem-free life, then that's not what the Bible's declaring. The Bible declares that God has a purpose behind every single one of our problems. And he wants to use those problems to perfect in you. It's a character thing. These momentary troubles, they'll go away. Look what it says in your word, in your notes. 2 Corinthians, for our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. It's not what happens to us. It's also what happens within us.